How you doing?
Good. Well, I was going to ask you specifically about the tackles, and first and foremost about this Nurtherin kid. He's come over from defense, and he's already working with the ones. That's a rather rapid. Has he just picked it up quickly, or is it just because there's no one else?
Well, I think it's twofold. We got a little saying here, you know. If you don't know where you're going, go there at full speed, you know, and Northern makes full speed mistakes. And I'll take a full speed mistake a lot more than I'll take a guy who's going to feel his way through. And so Northern has no clue right now what he's doing in this grand sense to validate working with the ones. But as far as effort and the way he's playing, he deserves to be there by the way he's playing. Now you turn on the tape and he's a bust a minute, but he's going full speed. And that's all you can ask. And he's been put in a tough situation, and you know, I told him I gave him 6 days I'm just going to be real, you know, just, hey man, we got to learn how to do this. And I said, by about the sixth day, you should have an idea of where you're going.
And then we're
going
to start getting on you.
Yeah. Right. And so I've been getting on him a little bit, and I think he's at a saturation point right now. To his credit, he hadn't said crap.
Right.
He just gets in the huddle and keeps playing. And he hasn't missed a rep the entire spring.
Right. And then I guess Gaston is working at the spot where Heap is listed as the starter.
Yes, Gaston's
working
there.
What do you see now?
I'm telling you what, Joey Gaston, as far as offensive lineman, making strides from his freshman plebe experience to now, Joey's going to be a good player. Mm-hmm. He's 6'5", 282 pounds. I'm very, very pleased with Joey. He's got a long way to go. He's taking every single rep at tackle also with the ones. And, you know, you hope that Joey doesn't have to play next year.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
give him another year.
Yeah, give him another year. I feel like we've stolen a whole bunch of reps, you know, or Joey has, that he wouldn't have gotten had we not had these injuries.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really hard when you're running with the ones, essentially your twos and threes, you know, are your starters. And so these guys have been put in a real tough situation. They haven't complained. They haven't said a single word. They've come to work, and they're getting better incrementally.
Right. Now, obviously, Heap and
Vickers
will have a chance to come back next year and show that they're the starters, and they do have the leg up based on their experience. Who else is out in that mix? Watkins, is he a tackle?
Paul Watkins is a tackle also.
Van Hollinger.
All these guys, I think if you go back and look at the starts that the tackles have had, sometimes they change. Barker got his first start his junior year against Air Force.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for me, in the same way we moved Dowd to guard, you know, 2 weeks before the Maryland game, we're going to get our best five there.
Mm-hmm.
These guys know that Joey's stealing reps right now. And if he duplicates what he's done so far in the fall, there's going to be some. He's a big old boy now.
Challenge.
And they know it, and the guys know it, and I preach it. Everybody's got to go. You know, you got to go earn your way. Heap's coming back from a broken leg. Graham's coming back from a shoulder injury. There's no guarantee they're going to come back. You hope they come back at least what they were, but there's no guarantee they're going to come back any better.
Right.
These guys all have an opportunity, and I give my guys all opportunities to get some plays in the field. Same thing can be said for the guys inside. You know, I mean, Thomas Stone had a chance to, get in the mix. Also, he hurt his eye, you know, so he's been out, you know, and that's given EK every single rep with the left guard. And so, you know, it's blessings for some, curses for others.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
All right.
Appreciate it, boss. Well, I was talking to Coach Niemeyer the other day about the situation on the offensive line, and the good news is that you're getting a lot of reps for young guys, but
right.
The bad news is that the guys who are supposed to be the starting offensive line aren't getting out here working. Does that concern you at all?
Well, I wish they were here. And then the first few days, you know, they're sitting over here in these red jerseys, and they're not involved. We didn't think they were engaged enough.
I was just going to ask about that.
Yeah.
What do you do to keep these guys?
Well, we called them out, and we told them we want them more engaged. And every time those young guys come back from running a play to be in the huddle there, listening to the play, coaching them up, helping them up, they have done a great job since then.
Mm-hmm.
And their key, you know, their deal is stay engaged, help the young guys get better, mentally take all the reps, and then obviously get themselves healthy so they're ready to go in the fall. So I'm happy with what they've been doing, considering obviously that they're not out here. EK, Benz, he's got a chance to be a starter for. He's taking basically every rep. He's doing a nice job for us. Ben Tamburillo, a freshman, who's running with the ones now, has done a great job. He's gotten a lot of reps. Joey Gaston, Northern, has come over from defense, is doing a good job. I'm trying to think who else we're running. trying to think. And the centers, you know, Brandon Green
and
then Blaze Ryder. They've right. done a nice job. It's been great for them.
Right.
Obviously, we'd rather have the other guys with us, but, you know, it is what it is. Obviously, right. they had surgeries. There's not much we can do about it. So I think we've gotten better. Obviously, mm-hmm. it hurts having 5 or 6 of your top guys or 7 of your top guys out.
Right. Who are the other? Obviously, Zuzek and Vickers were never going to do spring.
Right.
Then all of a sudden, Heap and Fleming decided they weren't going to go.
Right.
And or you.
Well, each one of those guys had surgeries.
Right.
So Fleming is doing limited stuff. He's just not going against the defense live.
Right. And then was there a couple backups that are also out?
Well, we've got Nate Otto, mm-hmm. who's a backup, had a surgery. Colin Watkins, who's played some for us.
Right, he's also surgery. Not out here.
Right, so there's 5 right there. And then EK got injured one day.
Right.
I think there's even more. Blake Benjamin's a young guy that we think's got a chance to be a good player.
Right,
he's down with a surgery also. So we're 6 or 7 guys down.
Right. Now, obviously, Zuzek and Vickers played enough that they know what they're doing. But don't you think that Fleming and Heap could have probably used the work? They're still young guys that hadn't
right.
played.
Well, Fleming started most of the year,
right.
so he got a lot of work.
Right.
So he's kind of in the same boat. But yeah.
Heap's going back out to tackle after
right.
having spent some time.
No, they all need it because they were all sophomores.
Right.
So they all need all the reps they've missed.
Well, let me ask you specifically about Tamborello. The kid, he was a center, listed as a center coming into the spring.
Right.
When did you decide to move him to guard? And what has he shown you to jump up there to, you know, basically working with the ones with the guys out?
We just moved him to guard out of necessity, to
mm-hmm.
be honest with you. We didn't have any other guards. We knew he was athletic. We're not sure if that's where he'll end up. You know,
mm-hmm.
he could be a center one day, maybe a tackle one day. He's an athlete. He's a good kid. He just gets in the huddle and he keeps working.
Right.
You know, he doesn't say anything.
And what about EK Benz? There's a kid that was, you know, coming in. I think you thought you had a good ball player there. Number one, did he get any reps last year? Did he traveled? Did he?
He did. He played a little bit.
Okay.
He played some. He reminds me a lot of Josh Cabral as
really?
A young guy.
Okay.
Which obviously is a high compliment. Now he's going to have to prove it on Saturdays. He may actually be more talented than Josh, but he's got a lot of the same characteristics. He's tough. He's a hard worker. Very smart. You tell him one time to do something, he gets it. He gets concepts in football.
Right.
So I think he's got a bright future. Another one, Thomas Stone, who started a game or two for us last year, is another guy that's out.
Right.
But the combination of Thomas Stone, Jake Zuzek, and EK Benz, that's 3 pretty good guards.
Right.
And then you got Tamborello behind that. You know, he's running with ones. Maybe he's the 4th guy in the fall.
Mm-hmm.
Then you've got Fleming back, you got Brandon Green, you got Blaze Ryder. That's 3 pretty good centers.
Right.
And then Chris, you know, feels the same way out of tackle. So we feel like we got a good group, and now we've created some depth because of these injuries. Now, obviously, we got to get them back healthy.
Right.
We got to get those guys back and got to get those guys to not only pick up where they left off, but they need to play at a much higher level next year than what they did this past season.
Right. So I guess, is there any chance that the guys who are working now in the spring could overtake or at least challenge? I mean, are they making a move on guys who are out, or do you think that's not fair?
Well, if we played today, they'd be the starters. So,
yeah.
I mean, it's those guys are going to have to come back out here and
prove themselves.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah,
okay.
No doubt.
All right, thanks, Coach.
All right,
appreciate
take care.
It.
Yep.